Good morning and welcome to day 14 of our prayer and devotion. We've been talking about prayer from yesterday. We talked about the power of prayer. Today I want to talk about how do we make our prayers powerful. In James chapter 5, James talks about the way we can make our prayers powerful. Verses 13 onwards, chapter 5 verses 13. Is anyone among you is suffering? He should pray. Is anyone cheerful? He should sing praises. Is anyone among you sick? He should call for the elders of the church and they should pray over him with the after anointing him with the olive oil in the name of the Lord. The prayer of faith will save the sick person, and the prayer and the Lord will raise him up, and if he has committed sins, he will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed. The intense prayer of a righteous person is very powerful. Elijah was a man with a nature like ours, and yet he prayed earnestly that it would not rain, and for 3 years and 6 months it did not rain on the land. Then he prayed again, and the sky gave rain, and the land produced its fruit. My brothers, if anyone of among you strays from truth and someone turns him back, he should know that whoever turns a sinner from the error of his ways will save his life from the death and cover multitude of sins. This passage, the concluding passage in the book of James, talks about how ordinary people can become people of extraordinary power simply by prayer. Prayer is, chances are that many times we pray, but we don't really, first of all, believe in the power of prayer. The second thing is we don't really understand the power that our prayers can carry, our prayers, and then we don't really know how to make our prayers powerful. So I want to give you a few pointers towards how do we make our prayer powerful. Number one, prayer is made powerful when practiced regularly, effectively, effectually, if you want to use that word. Basically, all I'm saying is when you continually pray, you will become more and more powerful in your prayers. That's what he was saying in chapter 5, verses 16. Pray for one another that you may be healed. The intense prayer of a righteous man is very powerful. Prayer is powerful when you practice it effectually. So learn to pray. The thing is this, that Luke, in the book of Luke, you would see many instances where Jesus took off time and prayed. Prayer practiced regularly will become effective, will become strong and powerful. If you pray for 1 day or 2 days, or if you pray only for one season, if you pray only when circumstances are not good, then the kind of prayers that we pray may bring results because God still loves us, but they're not as effective as they should be. That's why if you want to see your prayers become powerful and effective, pray regularly and practice it regularly like Jesus did. Learn to pray. Prayer is made powerful when we practice it regularly and effectually. Number two, prayer is made powerful when we do it fervently, passionately. That's what it means. That's why, again, going back to James, he's talking about Elijah, and he's saying, this is a man who prayed with passion. His prayer has something like a fervency inside it. Get passionate about praying. If you're doing it more like a duty, you don't really enjoy your prayer. What you and I need to understand is this, that prayer is our privilege given to us to communicate with God on a very personal level. Get passionate about it. Enjoy praying. Pray with anger, if you're fighting against evil forces, if you want to see somebody's lives changed, pray with that kind of agony. Show your emotions. That's what I mean when I'm asking you to pray passionately. Prayer is made powerful when you pray passionately. Number three, prayer is made powerful when it is done righteously. That's a very important thing. You see, the fervent prayer of a righteous man is effective. So that means if my life is not correct, if I'm not a righteous person, if I don't have a clean heart, then my prayer does not have a power. In Psalm 34, verses 15, the psalmist talks about how the eyes of the Lord watch over those who are righteous. The ears of the Lord are always open to the righteous man, righteous people, the cries of a righteous person. So God's eyes, God's ears are more open to a righteous man. When that's why further going down in the same psalm in Psalm 34, David says this: a righteous man may fall into many troubles, but the Lord comes to rescue him each time. So the prayer, our prayer is made more powerful when we are righteous people, when we follow the will of God in obedience. So obey God in every aspect of your life. Obey the word of God in every aspect of your life. Sometimes even if you don't like the will of God, you still follow that, so that when you pray, that becomes powerful. Prayer is made powerful when we do it with understanding. You see, most of our prayers are more detail-oriented, more repetitive, more religious. We think the length of our prayer decides the power of our prayer. That's wrong. Because Jesus made that extremely clear in Matthew chapter 6, talking about prayer. He said, don't pray and blabber on and on and on, and on like people who don't know. People from other faiths and other ideologies, they keep repeating prayer like a mantra, as if it is something that if I can keep repeating, something good will happen. But the truth is this, that prayer is not a formula for us to simply repetitively say. When you pray words without understanding what you're praying, without understanding what do you mean by saying whatever you're saying, then that prayers don't have any effect at all. So even if it's a short prayer, but with a full conviction, clear understanding, that prayer becomes more powerful. That's what Jesus was trying to point out to us. Prayer is made more powerful when you pray it with understanding. Prayer is made more powerful without eloquence. Sometimes we don't know how to pray. We wonder how to pray. We think that there is a particular way to pray. There is a particular words that we must use to pray. We don't have the right vocabulary to pray. That's why we hesitate to pray. Truth is this. For God, even a heart cry that comes after your heart without any words, a groan itself is a prayer. In fact, the Holy Spirit is given to us to do that, exactly the same thing. In Romans chapter 8, Paul talks about why the Holy Spirit was given to us. He says this in Romans chapter 8, verses 26 and 27, that the Holy Spirit helps you when you don't know how to pray. He will pray from your heart. He will intercede for us with groans and moans, he says. Further, he goes, and one more step, he does this. That when you don't know the will of God, Holy Spirit will pray that God's will be done in your life. What an amazing gift that God gave us through Holy Spirit. That even when we don't know how to pray, he will pray on behalf of us. And then when we don't know what to pray, he will pray what to pray. Brilliant. So when you allow the Holy Spirit to take control of your life, your prayer becomes more and more eloquent and powerful. Prayer is made more powerful by not quitting. In the beginning of this devotion, I told you prayer is made powerful when you practice regularly. Now, again, I'm coming back to similar thought, but on the other side is this. Prayer is made more powerful with persistence. Remember the persistent widow that Jesus talked about? That she wanted to get justice for her life, but kept going back to the judge who was corrupt, but kept going back to him and kept knocking on his door day and night, sometimes in the middle of the night, to get justice. And finally, this corrupt judge, looking at the persistence of the widow, decides that he will do justice to her. So then Jesus goes on to say, if a corrupt judge himself is moved by the persistence of a widow, imagine our God, who is a perfect judge. So prayer is made more powerful by not quitting. Not quitting. That's something you need to remember. Paul, that's why, whether it is in Romans, whether it is in Galatians, whether it is in Colossians, whether it is in Thessalonians, constantly reminds the church to pray consistently. Pray consistently. One word he repeats again and again as a reminder to the church, hey, pray consistently, because that brings power into your prayer. So prayer is more made more powerful by not quitting. Let me close off with this, an interesting thought. Prayer is made powerful by fasting. You see, fasting prayer helps us to overcome greater obstacles in our lives. There was a time in Matthew chapter 17, you'll see this incidence of a father who brought his child who was demon possessed, and the disciples did their best to cast the demons out. Jesus was away, he was praying. Later when Jesus came down, he with one word cast the demon out, and the disciples were amazed at the way this happened. They came to Jesus and asked Jesus, "Jesus, we tried to do this. I mean, we had the same faith." Then Jesus looks at him and says, "This kind of thing can only happen with fasting and prayer." So there are some things, some obstacles, some problems that can only be dealt by fasting and prayer. Prayer, when it is merged with fasting and prayer, fasting, it becomes really powerful. It kind of creates a nuclear bomb effect, you know, to remove any kind of obstacles from your life. So I challenge you to fast and pray if you're facing a really tough, difficult task at work, tough, difficult issue at family, in relationship, regarding your dream. Fast and pray, and you will see the power of fasting and praying. But remember that if you are not clean in your heart, or if you are not praying regularly, consistently, fasting would not work again. So you need a fasting prayer tempered by consistency and regularity and clean heart. It becomes like a, you know, dynamite in your hand, prayer. There's one thing that I want you to remember. A.J. Gordon said this: you can do more than prayer after you prayed, but you can never do more than prayer until you prayed. Remember that. You can do more than prayer after you have prayed, but you can never do more than prayer until you prayed. You see, your voice can bring a powerful transformation. Your voice that is sent up to heaven can bring a powerful transformation in your life and through your life. Pray. Pray consistently and regularly. God bless you.